Hey there, networking pros. A quick and simple video on fiber optics so that you can sound like you sort of know what you're talking about. Definitely not going to try to turn you into an expert. In fact, I'm not even an expert. And for those of you who are familiar with the videos that I make, I typically try to boil down the core essentials without going into a lot of theory so that you can get what you need in a short amount of time. So let's get started. Fiber optics, there's a few things I need you to know if you ever have to work with somebody who's trying to help you or get you to do something with fiber optics. First of all, so these are fiber optic cables. I think we all know that the way fiber optic works is it carries light through glass or plastic through a cable to the other side. The unique thing about fiber optics is it can carry data, large amounts of data, over very long distances. So first thing, since we're talking about distance, is the difference between multimode and single mode. So two types, okay? Multimode and single mode. Now, just briefly, multimode is typically used for intra-building type connections, like from one switch to another or from one data room to another. The single mode is typically for long distances, like 2 to 20 miles. So that's the stuff you see out on the telephone poles. And the way you can tell the difference is that oftentimes the cables won't have it written on them, but what you can do, and I know it's kind of small on the camera, so I'm not going to try to show you on the camera, but if you look closely, somewhere on the writing on the cable, it will have what's known as a micron size. I don't know if you can see that, but right there it's saying 62.5 and 125. So the 62.5 is the inner diameter in microns of the cable, of the fiber optic conduit inside. It's teeny, all right? 62 or 50 typically means multimode. Anything like down around 10 or 9 or 8 microns usually means single mode. Okay, the reason that's important is you can't mix them. You can't use a single mode cable where a multimode is expected and vice versa. Okay, the second thing you need to know about is the cable connector types. So right now I'm holding in my hand what's known as an SC. And the way I've always memorized that is SC sort of sounds like, makes the sound of the beginning of the word square. I know square is actually SQ, but anyway, that worked for me. SC is the square connectors. Then there's ST, Sierra Tango, and that's these kind of round barrel connectors where they have the real long tips sticking out. So that's SC. And then the last one, and these are the most common ones I see. There are more. There's actually more than just what I've got here. But the last one I want to show you is LC. Which supposedly stands for Lucent Connector, although it's easy for me to remember it as Little Connector. So LC. So LC, ST, SC, Sierra, Charlie. Okay, so now, can you mix connector types? Yes, you can. So these just happen to be equally symmetrical patch cords, but there are such things as patch cords where you can mix the types. Not types of cable, but types of connectors. So see, here's a patch cord where I've got SC on one side and ST on the other. All right, so we talked about cable types, multimode and single mode. We talked about the connectors. There's another connector I don't have, which is known as, I think it's MTRJ, which is a little tiny guy, and I don't see much of it. In fact, I'll tell you, just from my experience, used to see the ST and the SC a lot back in the last decade. I don't see it as much anymore, except on older equipment. Typically, what I see about 90% of the time now is these LC connectors. Okay, so we talked about cable types and cable type connectors. So what do these things do, or what do they plug into? Well, they plug into what's known as transceivers. Transceivers are the things that generate and receive the light. Now, they can either be standalone devices like this, or they can be built into switches or into routers. So you may notice these next time you're looking at a Cisco switch or Cisco router, you'll see the little transceiver sticking out. And basically what happens, so here I've got a transceiver which converts to Ethernet, and it's got SC connectors on it. So what happens is the SC connectors fit in. They're keyed. They're not always keyed like this. Sometimes they come loose like that. But I'm going to show you something really important in just a minute. Okay, so see how that fits in there? All right, do you notice here how on this transceiver I've got a TX and an RX? Now, you're not always going to be lucky enough to have those designations on some of the equipment you're going to work with. But here's the key thing I want you to know. When you're connecting two transceivers together, which is typically the case, you're always going to want to have a crossover, meaning that whatever's coming out of transmit or TX needs to go into the RX on the other side. Does that make sense? So when light is being transmitted out of this port, it needs to go into the RX on the other port. So if you're ever working with fiber and you can't get a connection to work, there's two things you can do. One is to make sure that it's flopping or it's flipping between your two transceivers where it's crossing over. The second thing you can do is just, if you've got the, if it's not working, you might as well just go ahead and take the chance, is just go ahead and pull them out and flip it over and see if that solves your problem. Okay, and another newbie thing a lot of us do, and I gotta admit, sometimes I even still do it, but you really should not, is don't look into these to see if you can see light. Reason why, it's laser. It's not good for your eyes. So don't stare into transceivers that are powered on. Don't stare into the end of these fiber cables when they're live, because that laser light in your eye is not doing you any favors. All right, in the next video we will talk about the ways that you can use fiber to expand your network, and about roughly how much it costs and what it takes, and what it can do for expanding your local area network. All right, hope that helps you out. Thanks so much for watching.